So we're talking about energy, we're talking about something called conservation of energy. And we'll be talking about what conservation means. To some extent, what conservation of energy means is that if you can write down a mathematical expression that accounts for all the energy in a system, and this system's isolated in some way, then that number will stay the same, no matter what happens in the system. But what we're gonna do, this is a cart, weighs about a kilogram, and I'm gonna push it uphill like this. You've seen that motion before, right? Now, here's the system we're talking about. Once my hand gets off of this cart, nothing else is affecting it, because remember, these carts have really low friction. You know, so there's not much friction on this. Once I let go of it, nothing's happening to it except for one thing. There's a force on it. What's that force from? Gravity. I want you to sketch position time, velocity time, and acceleration time graphs for this cart. It's given a quick push, and you don't have to, it moves up, slows down, and then return. Now, here's the thing I want you to do, and there's a good reason for this. I want you to start when it's still and include my push. All right? I'm giving it a quick push. So you can just draw what a quick push would cause with velocity, acceleration, and distance. All right? Please do that individually now on your sheet. Okay, have you had time? All right. Would you please turn to your neighbors and see if you can come to some agreement? Okay, I've heard some interesting discussion. Now, would somebody like to tell me what their group has to say? For instance, about what would the velocity look like? First, we start out here. It's obviously what? Zero. We give it a push. It goes up. It comes back. Anybody want to tell me about velocity? Okay, did you hear that? Probably not. It rises up to some value, then there's a straight line, right, down through the origin, comes down, and then what happens at the end when I catch it?
Goes back to zero.
Goes back to zero. All right, now finally, what does a position look like?
Parabola.
A parabola.
Opening down.
An inverse parabola, a parabola opening down, yeah. Is that right? Okay, so it looks like this. Why does a parabola have that shape? Or what's the mathematical function that describes that?
Function of the square.
A squared term of some sort. Okay, let's do it and see what we get. Now, I want you to pay particular attention to the top again. And I want you to pay attention to the push and the catch. Here we go. Okay, now, first question I want to ask you is, how do you know where it turns around? Velocity is zero. Can you see this little pointer here? So it's right there, right? What's the value of acceleration when it turns around? Did it go to zero? Okay. All right, now let's look at the distance or position. The parabola. It is. So you're absolutely right about that. What other things are described by this motion?
Throwing a coin in the air.
Throwing a coin in the air is a good example. With trajectories, you know what a trajectory is? Like, you know, with something sort of shot like this, then the part that goes up and down is described by this motion. The total mechanical energy, the energy that has something to do with position or movement, is what you're going to predict next. I want you to write down the total mechanical energy from the push, include the push and the catch, and beforehand. Please write down your individual prediction.
Okay, I'd like you to turn to your neighbors and discuss this.
Can somebody report their group result, your group result for the mechanical energy after the push and before the catch?
Constant.
What?
It's a constant.
A constant. What does constant mean? What will it look like? Straight line across, okay. So what happens to the mechanical energy when I give it a push? Louder, please.
Increases.
It increases. Where does it increase to?
Constant.
Okay, now what happens when I catch it?
Zero.
Decreases to zero. Okay, now. If I were to say to you, suppose you're right about this. Well, maybe we should look first. Let's see if you're right. Same data we've been using all along, you know, I rolled it up. Now I've hidden the result right here, and now I'm going to show it. Were you right?
Yes.
You bet.